Good evening, everyone. Lovely to see so many people here. I'm Craig Williams. I'm the Dean of Research Education in the Division of Health Sciences. That sounds sort of more grandiose than it is. The Division of Health Sciences is really it's a collection of schools. We have four schools: School of Population Health, School of Nursing and Midwifery, School of Health Sciences, and School of Pharmacy and Medical Sciences. But the people are the real capital of the Division of Health Sciences, and those people extend beyond the schools through our connections into the South Australian Health and Medical Research Institute, the SAMRI, Centre for Cancer Biology, and we have our friends from the Ian Walk Research Institute here this evening, just to name a few. Before I go much further, I'd just like to acknowledge that, you know, we meet tonight on the land of the Kaurna people, and we respect and acknowledge their ongoing and enduring connection with this land. And it's a special place, and it's a special place for the Kaurna people, but for me, this place that's kind of bounded by North Terrace and the river at the other end, it's very much the cultural, intellectual heart of the state. I've been really lucky. I've sort of lived, I don't live very far away, but I've sort of worked and misspent a lot of time in this region. And, you know, you can take a short walk up North Terrace and you can see the site where the first school in this state was ever built, the first church. And if you keep on walking, then you can see where the newest health and medical research institute in the country exists. So it is a special place. It's a great place to spend time and work. And for me, it is kind of the intellectual heart of this state. And people who don't work here, like people who work at Mawson Lakes campus, that's the intellectual heart too, just not as much. All right. So what to expect of tonight? You know, what are we doing here? I mean, this is about encouraging research degree students to come and make a choice to do the research training here at UniSA, and specifically in the Division of Health Sciences or in health science related topics and fields. Tonight we've got a whole host of research labs, research staff, lecturers, academics, you know, research fellows here to talk to potential students. They are here and they're next door when we, you know, decamp afterwards for some food and networking. There's a whole suite of posters and tables set up for you. If you're interested in a PhD or master's by research, you can find out more. So it's about student recruitment. And what better way to recruit students than to tell everyone how great it is and to show them that. And so with that, this is a showcase event for the research that is done in health sciences. Tonight you'll hear from early career researchers, people who've made that step from a PhD and are now in the next phase of their career, and they'll reflect on what they went through and the things they're doing now, give you an idea of, you know, forecasting ahead. You'll hear from current PhD students to tell you, you know, how much fun it is and how challenging it can be to be a PhD student, and about, you know, the different journeys people take. And I know I'm sort of meant to make a note to myself, don't use the word journey. You know, no hugging and kissing and crying. It's not reality TV, but it is reality what you'll hear about PhD students talking about, you know, the things that really affect them and how they're doing. So naturally, we've chosen people tonight who will just give you really good news and never tell you about any of the bad things that happen. You'll also see tonight our three-minute thesis division final. So the three-minute thesis, for anyone who hasn't seen this before, it's a PhD thesis in 3 minutes. And it's just a fantastic sort of microcosm of someone's research effort condensed into this very short package of time. It's a competition. The three people you hear from tonight have been through a heat and have won through to here, and then two of those people will be going on to the university grand final, and then if they win that, onto a national Trans-Tasman final. So, you know, it's a big nationwide competition and it's a fantastic event. Right, so what I'd like to do now is just take you on the, you know, a cook's tour of the research environment here in the Division of Health Sciences. And some of this, not all of it, but a good chunk of it centres and is captured within what's called the Sansom Institute for Health Research. This guy's Lloyd Sansom. He was my head of school years ago. He, you know, is a very famous pharmacist and pharmacy regulator. And though the institute's named after Lloyd, who's done an amazing amount of work for this country. And really, his work was in medicines and pharmacy. And so, you know, there is a real research strength in drug development, the way people use drugs, and the epidemiology and effectiveness of all of this. So there are a number of research groups in quality use of medicines and that sort of thing. Drug development is very big. It's a big part of the research effort, and not only drug development, but the formulations of those drugs. You know, how we use existing drugs, how we formulate them for better delivery, how we monitor that delivery, you know, to improve people's health. course, the studies aren't always about, you know, the good drugs, the drugs that are new or the old drugs done better that improve people's health, but also transcend into, you know, illicit drugs, drugs of dependence. And so we have research groups that consider the effects of drugs of dependence, not only on the physiology and neurobiology of people and how they experience things like pain and emotion, but right through to considering other aspects of them around their mental health. We have research groups in major research concentrations in neuroscience, but also in mental health and substance abuse, and that sort of thing. So it's really spanning the whole breadth of everything to do with medicines and drugs. Exercise physiology, locomotion, that is a big research focus here, particularly in the School of Health Sciences. Seeing here, this is, the guy doesn't look like he's having a good time, does it? Running on a treadmill. It looks like a Port Adelaide football, which reminds me there's a new partnership between us, between our university and the Port Adelaide Football Club. Education and research partnership about to be launched. Of course, it's not always about elite athletes, although we have research degree students, PhD students, you know, with athletes that have just been to the Commonwealth Games, following Olympic athletes, and some of our own PhD students are elite athletes. But it's not always about the elite. It's about people every day, you know, living, exercising, and eating well. And so we've got researchers in nutritional physiology, considering all aspects of people's lives, you know, through to avoiding diabetes and cardiovascular disease, through to, you know, the things that enable them to recover from stroke, for instance. The research transcends into other aspects of health, infectious diseases, microbiology, virology, and the development of new vaccines to treat diseases, and even vaccines to treat cancer. Our experimental therapeutics group, and you hear from one of the students from that group tonight in the 3-minute thesis, are very much at the cutting edge of new vaccine development. We've got researchers still studying the inner mechanisms and workings of the cell, you know, in a bid to rid us, or to at least to treat some of the worst disorders and diseases caused by cellular malfunction. And recently, this has just recently been formalised, our partnership with the Centre for Cancer Biology, which has actually become part of UniSA. And the research, the large number of researchers, many of whom will be here tonight next door with their the posters and the tables to tell you about their research and to hopefully, you know, pique your interest in the searches for, you know, for new treatments, new ways to buy people time and to improve their lives and resolve disorders like cancer. We've got researchers studying bone and musculoskeletal disorders and diseases. Researchers considering all aspects of physiology, lung physiology, for instance. And then, of course, our research groups that consider the health of individuals before they're born and how the maternal environment, the in utero environment, tracks with their health as adults. Our mothers and babies research group considers all aspects of the care and treatment of individuals centered around the mother-child experience. And, of course, Our research teams in nursing and midwifery are considering all aspects of healthcare delivery and doing it better. Our newest school, it's been around for a little while now, School of Population Health, actually based at the, very impressive here in this photo, the Samri building. I like to think of it as the cheese grater, but I think there's a few names for it going around, up the other end of North Terrace. People are considered the role of place, the suburb you live in, you know, the race you are, how close you are to the shops or a bus stop, and the influences of that on your health. And of course, tied in with that, the Wardley Purringa Aboriginal Research Unit, I believe representatives from that group are here tonight, who are involved with SAMRI, linked in with SAMRI, one of the major research arms within SAMRI, considering the health specifically of Indigenous Australians in modern society. In terms of facilities, of one of our schools, and of course the WARU, the Wardley Purringa Research Unit, based at SAMRI, we've got our new Exercise Physiology Elite Performance Centre there, pictured at bottom left, a clinical trials facility. I've spent the week in there doing research. It's you know, you just don't have these at every university, these sort of customised clinical trial facilities that can be used by research students and staff. And of course, with an eye to the future, the new Centre for Cancer Biology standalone building on North Terrace will be something that those folks in the Centre for Cancer Biology will be eagerly looking forward to, their own customised facility. So with that, that's the snapshot.